Hey everyone, welcome back. In for some short, sharp VO2 work. Feeling better than I did yesterday. Legs are still physically sore to touch. But all good. Still done my HIIT yesterday, but freshened up a fair bit. So today I'm not as sore. Like Tuesday was just terrible the way I felt. But that would have been getting used to the extra activity as well. Hopefully we can get through this nice and easy. I meant to do some threshold tomorrow. And then there's some new workouts I meant to do on Saturdays. Lactate shuttling instead of just a long, easy ride. So, see how I feel. Normally I'm a little bit wrecked after some threshold work, but we'll see. There's also some good races that I'd like to go in, but I need to make that decision before tomorrow, because if I do some threshold stuff tomorrow, I won't have recovered enough to do well in a race on Saturday. Not if I want to go my best. So, I don't know. I'd love to, but I kind of need to do a training block, I think, and then just dedicate to sort of like race, rest sort of thing. I need to start racing more. I'd like to try and work on my overall ranking. Need to go in some big races that's packed full of riders ranked higher. Let's try and go well and have some good finishes. Get the points up there. But yeah, I find can't do a full training block and race at the same time. Just doesn't work for me. If I just race, rest, I don't improve. Racing's meant to be the best training, but maybe I need to race a bit more often. Like maybe once a day, have every third day off, not sure. Probably need to get into a bit more of the competitive stuff. Be much more fun for people to watch races too, the training videos, I guess. I was looking at some of the higher ranked riders on Zwift. Unbelievable. The one guy there, 62, 63 kilos. and pumps out mid 700s for a minute. That is insane. And that's indoors. That's his Zwift numbers. What on earth could he do outdoors? I just can't. Fathom that. Like someone so tiny producing that much. So not only, so my best 1 minute I think 6:20 or something outside, that is. So inside I think we've done 5:60, but that was within another effort. So we'd be definitely good for 5 500s, somewhere around 600 anyway. But he's, I think, 740, weighs 62 kilos. Like, so all the training in the world and weight training and everything, I don't think I'd get to the point where I'll be producing over 700 inside. But if you take that out of it, my lean muscle mass now is more than his whole body weight. I'm about 64, 65 of lean muscle mass. I just can't get over how to produce that sort of numbers. It's amazing. When you got it, you got it. Just imagine the punch someone like that would have, like in the last 500 meters, 600 meters of a sort of steep uphill finish. Even if you were a sprinter, you can hang on. You got no hope in his 15 seconds was over 1,000. So you can sprint as well. Oh, hang on a sec. Yeah, it's just he's like a younger guy, 20s, in his 20s. Just phenomenal. I wasn't ready for that. Daydreaming. hopefully some people got something out of the video yesterday, going through my setup. Certainly bound to help a few people. Be good to hear from you. Or if you need clarification on anything. Just thinking I've got to try and enjoy this first week, because the second week is what destroyed me in the last vlog. And then I've got to have a bit of a laugh, because the second day of this first week, it's the worst I've ever felt on an indoor workout. Been thinking about getting a good GoPro camera to do some outside stuff for you when lockdown ends. Start getting some different little outdoor challenges, or actually go and chase some real KOMs. Very different outside, because Strava KOMs are the best ever on the course. A lot of the ones we go for here are just the best for the hour. So even though we go all right, if you take a deeper look, we're probably a fair way off. I don't even worry about looking, to be honest. Just when you see the ability of the Top Guns, it's a bit of a slap in the face, put you back in reality. But it's all about self-improvement. Heard a good line this morning while I was watching a YouTube video, and said, if you can't be the best in the world, at least be the best you can be. Which is exactly right. Oh, stream just disconnected. Hopefully it's back on. Stream, the internet's been a real issue lately. I'm trying to stream at really good quality, the best I can here anyway. Might have to turn it down. Although it didn't help. Last time I dropped the video bit rate, still disconnected. So the video will be in two parts on stream now. Legs are definitely, legs are feeling sore. Bit tired. Got to get past the soreness. It's like when you go to the gym for the first time, a couple of days later, so sore you can hardly move. I'm not that bad, but I started really light. But that's the soreness in my legs. Hopefully, get through these all right. enough. Legs are still tender. Hopefully they come good in a few days. Remember this finish from a few days ago? Two more. Well, I'm definitely feeling it more than I should. I have to say goodbye to the weight, the squats. Just gonna be doing weights a couple of times a week in the future. Do the rest of the HIIT, but no squats. Dunno. Suppose the more I stress the legs now, better I'll feel after a taper. But I've got to be able to get through the workouts. They don't really get easier than this. This would actually be the easiest ride in the whole program. And I am feeling it, so. It's not good. Oh, well, four more minutes of hurt. That's broken up. Well, the stream is disconnected again. It's not good. Oh, I'll get through this and have a nice light recovery ride. Let's roll. Really much fun. Half done. Definitely going to stop the squats. I was meant to do more and more every day. Legs just can't do this and that. Not at the moment. That felt longer. Two more. Oof. Feel harder than I should. Last one. Well, it's over. definitely doing too much with this, the HIIT and the diet. Gonna revisit that today. Not as much energy, trying to do more with it. Certainly not nice to have to struggle to work out. That should be this easy. But it's not as though we don't know why. It's all right. Just amazing the difference from your best day to your worst. It can all happen within a week. Can be hundreds of watts different. Legs don't even want to turn 2:30. Tomorrow's video will be very interesting. Good chance we won't do it. We'll start and won't get through it. Need a lot more energy than this. Just remember, if you're enjoying the videos, like them, share them, subscribe. Got a bet going with my wife on how many subscribers I can get before Christmas, before end of the year. Oh, it's finally feeling nice to turn the pedals. A big thank you to all the regular viewers on the YouTube and the Facebook. There's a few of you that are regularly checking in and liking everything. That's a big plus for me. It's good to know that you're watching and catching up with what's going on up here with me, and I certainly look forward to getting back and having a ride with this. Look forward to that very much, more than you realise. Well, we're coming to the end. Interesting to do some of these outside. I just don't have anywhere where I live that I can, and with the lockdowns I can't go anywhere anyway, but anywhere where I can do some set of efforts to see, like for example, there's eight of these, 30 on 30 off, what do they feel like at those spots outside? Could be really easy. My outdoor FTP might be really different to my indoor one, but I don't think so. I think they'd be pretty close now. Just the sprints are a fair way off. Well, end that one here. I want to go for another light roll. Enjoy. We'll talk again.